ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः
103 भौतिकत्वं पुरा प्रोक्तं सद्वक्तुं देह बाह्ययोः इन्द्रियद्वारतो बोद्धुं प्रोच्यते मरणक्रमः Indriyas, sense organs and organs of actions as the sadhana dwara for atmavabodha, to know what the atma swarupa is being considered now. Indriyas are bhautika. Bhautika means made up of bhutas element, just like the deha and external objects. So now to arrive at what Atma Swarupa is for gaining the knowledge of Atma through the Indriyas, the order in which the death takes place is being considered. Let us see what is that order of death. We have seen the Shruti, Purushasya Prayataha Vang Manas Sampadyati Manah Prani Pranah Tejasi Tejah Parasyam Devataya. This is now explained in two stanzas, 104, 105. म्रियमाणस्य वागादिवृत्तिर्मनसि लीयते मनोवृत्तेर्लयः प्राणे प्राणवृत्तेस्तु तेजसि म्रियमाणस्य वागादिवृत्तिः वागादिवृत्तिः जॉइन्ड बोथ Not separate, but one. It is a compound. Vagadinam vrittihi vagadi vritti. Not separate words. In one word. Vagadinam vrittihi vagadi vritti. Continuing. Manasi liyate. Mano vrittehi prane layaha. Mano vrittehi prane layaha. प्राणवृत्तेहे तु तेजसि अगेन लयः एड स्यात् मनोवृत्तेहे प्राणे लयः स्यात् आल्सो टू बी एडेड देन प्राणवृत्तेहे तु तेजसि लयः स्यात् म्रियमाणस्य द पर्सन हु इज ऑन द वर्ज ऑफ डाइंग वर्ज ऑफ डाइंग व्हाट हैपेंस वागादि वृत्तिः वृत्तिहि फंक्शंस द फंक्शंस ऑफ स्पीच साइट ऑल दीज सो व्हाट हैपन वेयर डू दे गो मनसि लीयते इट गेट्स मर्ज इन द माइंड मींस द पर्सन इज एबल टू नो बट नो जनरली इट हैपन्स नो डू यू रिकॉग्नाइज मी Do you recognize me? Do you hear me? Not nowadays. Nowadays, all tubes are poked in all holes. Additional holes also are made and tubes are inserted. Generally, a person who is ailing for a long time and is on the point of dying, is whether to know whether that he is aware of it. Do you recognize me? Who is this? The sun has come from a distant place now. Who is this? Like that they ask. Okay. So, he is not able to respond. He is not able to recognize. What is meant by not able to recognize? Eyes are there. Means the sight has gone now. It has merged in the mind. He is not able to speak. So that vagadi, all indriyas, this indriya vrittis functions, manasi liyate. Still he is feeling, etc. Means aware of whatever pain, etc. He is aware. That also goes now. Mano vrittehe prane layaha sya. Functions of the mind, already the indriyas have been withdrawn now, the functions of the mind, where they merge now, pranelayaha asya, prana in the pranas, because still the heart is pumping and few things are respiration is going on. So therefore, prana, but the mind is not aware of anything, you can say pama or whatever it may be, is not aware of the world around. Other people are wheeling, etc. He is not aware anything, he is not aware of prani. Then where the prana goes? Prana vritti hetu tejasi. Pranas have already left the body. Suksha sharira has already left the body. So tejasi in the fire. Why? Still the body has got the warmth. Now it is still lingering there. So that is how the indriyas through the mind merge where? In the prana. Prana in the teja. And we know teja is from where? Sadvastu. The cause is sadvastu. So how teja without that prana is? Teja also gives some indication. Of course, medical science may say something about the brain, death and heart, receiver. That's okay. But this was a simple way of the knowing the order of death. Chvasaha. Continuing that, how that tejasi, so which does the tejas indicate the life thing, presence of life? Shvasasyoparata ushnam sprishtva jivana nishchayam.
Shvasasyoparata ushnam sprishtva jivana nishchayam.
Kurvanti ushnam tu tat tejaha sadvastu niviliyate. Shvasasya uparatau ushnam sprishtva jivana nishchayam kurvanti. Ushnam tu tattejaha sadvastuni viliyate. Shvasasya uparatau. Now the shvasa breathing has stopped. Maybe very faint may be there, not totally. Very faint breathing may be there, but generally it is stopped now. Ushnam sprishtva jivana nishchayam kurvanti. So whether this person is alive or not. So ushnam sprishtva, they touch the body. Of course, doctor may feel the pulse, that is okay. But all people don't know what to detect the pulse, etc. But they go on the, that means olden days, they used to feel the body as such. If warmth is there, perhaps he may come back. Chances are there. So, that is our definition of death. Whether your brain or heart, let them discuss. Our definition of death is what? The person is not supposed to return to the body. So, if he returns, means he was not dead. That's all. Whatever may be the other, your anatomical or physiological condition, so if he returns this, he was not dead. So that's fine. So that is how it is. So they feel, that is, feel the body. So shvasasya uparatau. Then the shvasa breathing has stopped. Uparati stopped here. Stop. What the people do? Ushnam sprishtva. So touching the body, feeling the warm. Jivana nishchayam kurvani. If it is warm, they still feel that, means still person is alive. If it is totally cold, gone. That's why they say, if it warm, see, let us see something can be done or not, or something they think. So, jivan nishyam kurvanti. Then what about ushnam? What is that ushna, the warmth in the body? Ushnam tu tat tejaha. That warmth, that heat is nothing but the teja, the fire principle. Because heat belongs to fire, tejaha. And where does, finally, where it goes? Sad vastu niviliyate. It merges back in the sat vastu, which is cause as such. Finally, the sat is the mula of the karya. What are those? The indriyas vagadi. So therefore, indriyas, all these are what? Vacharambhanam vikaro namadeyam. So what is the truth is sat only. In this manner, through the indriyas, one can find out the one swarupa to be atma swarupa, sat swarupa, chaitanya swarupa. So now, having shown these three as atmavagati dwarani, what are those atmavagati dwarani? Chichaya sthula deha and indriya, where they were introduced in stanza 85 and explained from 74 to up to here 105. Why this was taught? As an introduction to show the brahmatva of jiva. This brahma in reality is nothing but jiva. You are aware of it. Okay. The jiva in reality is nothing but brahma. Okay. Then you reverse it. Brahma connected to jiva. Jiva in reality is nothing but Brahma. But Brahma, come on, due to ignorance, appears as though samsari jiva. Brahma, due to ignorance, appears as though maya, etc., that's fine, appears as though samsari jiva. But the samsari jiva in reality is nothing but Brahma. So this is not a pep talk, okay? So sorrow is so much in samsara. So therefore, look here, you are so great, you are Brahma, etc. Just to enthuse, no, this is the truth. Better we discover. If not yet discovered, at least have that Shraddha, this is the truth, and take to the means by which the mind can be prepared and this knowledge can be gained. And also, first have Shraddha. Shraddha in Shastra. Shraddha has to be in the Shastras. Who has given this Upanishad? Ishwara. It can't be otherwise. Maybe I am not able to know it, I am not able to verify the truth of it, but it can never be otherwise. It can never go wrong. That's why Shraddha is very important. So it gives the boost to the subsequent sadhanas that are required and one can take to them. So as an introduction to show the Brahma Swarupa of Jiva. And why Brahma Swarupa of Jiva has to be discovered? Thereby the samsaritva, jivatva of this individual gets terminated, gets eliminated. He discovers himself to be nothing but Brahma. So now, Shvetaketu, having given this basis, Shvetaketu is pointed out now, Shvetaketu, you are nothing but Brahma in reality. Tat Tvam Asi. Tat Tvam Asi is now being explained from 106 to 101. The corresponding Shruti Mantra is like this, 6, 8, 7. Sahayaha. O Shvetaketu, Sahayaha. Who is that? That one. What is that? Sadakhyaha. The one who is called as Sat. Eshaha Anima. He is this Eshaha. Anima. What is Anima? Anubhavaha. The most subtle means Jagataha Moolam. So the Jagataha Moolam. The mantra is Saya Esha Anima Etadatmyam Idam Sarvam Tat Satyam Atma Tattvam Asi Shvetaketu. This is the mantra having the first Tattvam Asi. 9 times it appears. Saya Esha Anima. You note that. Saya Esha Anima. Etadatmyam Idam Sarvam. Tat Satyam. Sa Atma Tattvam Asi. So word by word you'll see. Sahayaha. Who is the Sahayaha? Sadakhyaha. Who is called as Sat and we have now ascertained that Sat as the very cause of entire creation itself is what? Eshaha Anima. Anima, of these words will be explained in the verses also. Anubhavaha. Anima means Anubhava means Jagataha Moolam. It is the very cause of entire creation. Etadatmyam Idam Sarvam. Idam Sarvam. Sarvam is Jagat. Is Etadatmyam. Idam Sarvam Etadatmyam. What is that Etadatmyam? Etad means this Sat has its has entire Jagat has Sat as its Atma. Its Atma means Swarupa. So this entire Idam Sarvam means this entire Jagat. Sarvam stands for Jagat. Etadatmyam means this word has this. This means what? Sat as its Atma means as its Swarupa. That is what he said. Etadatmyam idam sarvam. Tat. Tat means that Sat. Refer to earlier. What's its nature? Satyam paramartha sat. It is the absolute truth. No change, no destruction, no beginning. Absolute reality, satyam. Saha, you can add eva. Verily that sat is what? Atma is the atma that the pratyaksha swarupa, the jagataha karanam, the cause of the jagat, the true I, therefore the shvetaketu, tat tvam asi shvetaketu. O Shvetaketu, tvam, you, asi, are, tat, that sat, which is the very basis of entire creation, is your Swarupa. So this is what is the first tatvamasi. Totally 9 times it has been told, the first tatvamasi, now being explained from 106 to 111. Chaya dehendriyadvarai padartho yotra bodhitaha. स एव सर्व जगतो निमा वस्त्वंतरं नतु अत्र छाया देहेन्द्रियद्रैः यः पदार्थः बोधितः सः एव सर्व जगतः एड मूलम् अनिमा वस्त्वंतरम नतु अत्र अत्र मीन्स इन दिस उपनिषद एंड हियर फ्रॉम स्टांजा 74 टू 105 छाया देहेन्द्रिय द्वारैहि साधनैहि थ्रू दीज मीन्स व्हाट आर दोस छाया व्हाट इज छाया इच्छाया व्हाट इज इच्छाया उपलक्षण फॉर जीव through the swapiti sleep, that was vector. Deha, sthula deha, indriya, indriyas, through this dvaraihi, through this means, yaha padarthaha, whatever the thing, what padartha? Sadakhyaha padarthaha, the vastu called sat, so padartha, bodhitaha, was revealed, was taught means was revealed, with this were used as atmavagati, dvara or sadhana. Atmavabodha, dvara or sadhana, whatever that padartha sadakhya was revealed, saha eva, so that sadakhya eva, alternated in it, ishaha also is there, is verily this, saha eva, sarva jagataha moolam, it is the moola, the karana, the basis of entire jagat. Also it is what? Anima. Anima means atisukshma. Atisukshma will be, anima etc. will be explained means indriyagochara, not an object of sense organs. Anima. And other than this, there is no cause for the word. Like nayayikas etc., vaisheshikas, they speak of paramano etc. These cannot be the cause of the word. So therefore, he refutes the other as the other than sat, there is no cause for the word. Vastvantaram natu. Vastvantaram, namely, like paramanu, etc., quoted by other schools of thoughts as the cause of the jagat, is not correct. That cannot be the jagat karanam. Now, this saya, esha, at, anima, etc., this shruti is going to be explained word by word. See, this jagat is perceptible, jagat comprising nama and rupa, is gross and is perceptible, indriya gamyam, with jagat, thulam jagat, this thula jagat, gross word, and what is its nature? Nama rupatmakam, it has got names and forms, it is gross in nature, is indriya gamyam, is perceptible through the indriyas. What about Advaita Sat? Indriya Gamyam or Indriyagamyam? Indriyaihi Agamyam. By Indriyas, including the mind, cannot be known as an object. As an object. As Vishayikarana, objectifying, you can't know Sat, Chaitanya, Brahma through Indriyas or the mind. So therefore, because it cannot be known through the Indriyas, it is called as what? Sukshma. Therefore, it is Sukshma. And for that, the Shruti uses the word Anima. So, that meaning of that Anima is now in 107 and the first line of 108. The Anima from the Shruti. Which Shruti? 6, 8, 7, Chandogya. Then, in the second line of 108, Aitadatmyamidam sarvam. That Shruti, the meaning is given. Aitadatmyamidam sarvam. First, Anima, then the second line of 108, Aitadatmyamidam sarvam is being explained. Sthulatvanutvarupabhyam vastvekam bhasate dvidham. Sthulamindriya gamyatvan nama rupatmakam jagat. Sadadvaitam bhavet sukshma mindriya vishayatvatah. Etadatmaka taivasya sthula setiha yojyate. There, vastvekam bhasate, just note the sandhi breaking, vastu ekam bhasate. Now take that ekam, then vastu, sthulatva anutva rupabhyam, sthulatva and anutva, either, sthulatva anutva rupabhyam, vidha bhasate, vidha bhasate. Sukshma, continuing 108. Sukshmam indriya vishayatvataha. So, indriyanam avishayatvataha. Indriya vishayatvataha. Sukshmam indriya vishayatvataha. Sad advaitam bhavi. Sad advaitam bhavi. Iha asya sthulasya etadatmakata yujyati. Iha asya sthulasya etadatmakata yujyati. Sthulam indriya gamyatvat namarupatmakam jagat ad bhavati. As it is. Sthulam indriya gamyatvat namarupatmakam jagat ad bhavati. Ekam vastu. What is ekam vastu? Namely, sat. Sad vastu. Sthulatvanutva rupabhyam. In these two forms, sthulatva, gross, sukshmatva, anutva, means sukshmatva, subtle. In terms of these two forms, as gross and subtle, vidhabhasati appears to be twofold. Vastu is one, appears to be twofold. Gross and subtle. What is that gross and what is that subtle? Let us see. Sthulam, that is the gross aspect of one and the same, sat. Indriya gamyatva, because it is perceptible through the sense organs. Indriya gamyatva, it is nothing but this. What is it? Nama rupatmakam jagat bhavati. It is the jagat of the having, comprising nama and rupa, names and forms. So, how it has become this, all that we have seen. In the creation, by Maya, etc., Bahubhavana, all that has been seen. What is the Sukshma aspect of the one and the same Sattvastu? Says, Sukshmam Indriya Vishayatvataha, being not an object of Indriyas. Avishayatvataha, being not an object, not a Vishaya of the Indriyas. So what is that? Sad Advaitam Bhavi. Sat Advaita is what? The Sukshma aspect. Means, one and the same Sat appears as Jagat. Jagat is not different from the Sat Brahma. But Jagat being Sthula is Indriya Gamya. Sat being Sukshma Indriya and not Vishaya of Indriyas. So this is what is called as Anima, the Sukshma, for which the contrast with the Sthula is being given. Now, Aitadatmyamidam Sarvam, that is explained there. Aitadatmya. What is that Aitadatmyamidam Sarvam, Shruti? Says, Iha. Iha means here. Here means where? Avaleshwar. There. In this Jagat, Asmin Srishtav, in this Srishti, in this creation, Asya Etadatmakata, Asya Sthulasya. Iha means Asmin Srishtav, in this creation, Asya of this Sthulasya. What is Sthulasya? Sthulasya Jagataha, of this gross world. Etadatmakata eva yujyate. Yujyate is proper. What is proper? Etadatmakata. Etadatmakata means having etad, means this sat as its atma, the swarupa. Atma also can mean swarupa, the true nature. So therefore what says, so iha, in his srishti, the jagat, for this sthula jagat, for the gross world, this is proper. What is proper? Etadatmakata. Etad means having this sat, that is what etad, as the very atma, the swarupa. We have seen now, entire jagat has got the basis, cause, where in the sat. That's what is the swarupa. So that is the true nature. And what about the jagat namarupatmaka vikara vacharambhanam vikaraha? So that is what yujyate. From what we have seen so far, it is but proper. Now further, the Shruti, Tat Satyam. So what is that Tat Satyam? Its meaning here in 109. Tat stands for Sat. Satyam means Paramartha Satvastu. That Shruti is now explained. Anutvam Vastu Na Proktam Yat Tat Satyam Avadhana. Sthulatvam maya kutam jnane naitasya badhana. Yat vastunaha anutvam proktam tat satyam. Add utaha. Second line. Etasya sthulatvam mayaya kutam. Further add utaha. Continue. Jnanena badhana. Yat vastunaha anutvam. Badhana. Earlier abadhana. First line abadhana, second line badhana. Where? Tat acha. Tat kutaha. Acha kutaha. Then continue abadhana. Okay. Yat vastunaha anutvam proktam tat satyam. Add kutaha. Continue abadhana. Yat. Yat here in the sense. Yat vastuna means yasya vastunaha. Which vastu means sat vastu. What was told earlier? Anima. Anutvam proktam. Anutvam sukshmatvam. Whatever that sukshmatva that was told with regard to sat vastu, that is what tat satyam, that sat vastu which is anu sukshma is what satya. What do you mean by satya? Trikala abadita, that which exists ever without any change or destruction. Kutaha, how do you say that is sat? Because we find this abadhanat, abadhanat kalatraye api nashabhava. Abadhanat means even in three periods of time, kalatraye api nashabhava, there is no nasha, destruction for that. Therefore, that sukshma vastu sat, that is what satyam. What about the jagat then? Etasya sthulatvam maya kluptam. Kluptam means projected. By what? Maya means that sthulatva of the jagat is what? Mayikam means maya karyam. Effect of maya. It's the effect of maya. And because it is effect of maya, what is nature? False in nature. Maya itself is false. And that being the case, because it is falsely projected, so therefore what? Etasya na jnanena badhana. How do you say it is false? Jnanena badhana. Because it gets negated, so by jnana. Be careful. It is negated by jnana, not by any other means. See, how can you kill the delusive snake which appears on the rope? Not other snake, not actual snake. Rope is mistaken as the snake. How can you kill it? Take a revolver and shoot it, is it? Or take a stick and beat it, is it? You have to see the base is the rope by light, nothing else. You may do all along, but that will continue. So, or scare away, no? So that it will not go. So therefore, likewise, here, jagat, you can negate where? Only in jnana. In jnana, what do you do? Just as you see the rope, directly cognize Atma Swarupa, Brahma Swarupa, jagat, no more there. Afterward, you need not. That means, remove it, it already gets terminated. So that badhana, because it gets negated. So, if this shows, if it were real means not kalpita, it will not get negated. That is why in sleep, jagat is not there. Don't ask. Swamiji, when I sleep, jagat is not there, but my neighbor was awake, therefore jagat was there, is it not? Yes or no? All nowadays, all nocturnals in the club, for jagat is there, we were sleeping, that is there. Jagat always individual. My jagat, what is my jagat? My world is sum total of my all experiences. That jagat may be there for the public as such, but my jagat is gone. Unless I experience, the jagat is not there. So therefore, so we are talking from the individual standpoint, and that why arriving at Atma Swarupa. So, and that's why even if one person gains knowledge, the jagat is gone for whom? That person. Other idiots continue. Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi janani jathare shayanam. So that continues. So therefore, always it is individual, not my neighbor is awake and jagat is left. That is not the argument. So therefore, he says, that is, if it were real, it can't be kalpita, and that is not, it cannot have the nasha. The very fact that jagat gets terminated in knowledge, and with knowledge again not picking up information, that is paroksha. That is fine. First step necessary. But proceed further. Have aparoksha jnana, direct cognition. Jagat get terminated. Satma tattvam asi shvetaketu. This needs to be elaborated. The first line explains now Saatma of this mantra 687. The remaining second, that is tattvam asi shvetaketu, explained in second line of 110. Saha Atma, with that Atma, abadhyoya sa eva Atma, sarvasya natu kalpitaha.
Abadhyoya sa eva Atma, sarvasya natu kalpitaha.
श्वेतकेतो यदद्वैतं तदसि त्वं न मानवः यः अबाध्यः सः एव सर्वस्य आत्मा न तु कल्पितः श्वेतकेतो यद् अद्वैतम् एड सत तत तद तत त्वम असि न मानवः न मानवः यः द वन हु इज लाइक दिस अबाध्यः वैसे अबाध्य मीन्स दैट विच इज अणु दैट विच इज सत्य सो दैट अबाध्य नॉट निगेटेड नॉट डिस्ट्रॉयड नॉट सब्जेक्ट टू डिस्ट्रक्शन सहा एव रियली दैट ओनली सर्वस्य आत्मा आत्मा आई ऑफ एवरीवन सी सर्वस्य आत्मा डोंट थिंक माय आत्मा एंड योर आत्मा इज हु सैतान सर्वस्य आत्मा दैट ऑल्सो शोज आई इन टू आई इन मी इज द ट्रू आई इन ऑल दैट इज वाई इट इज सेड सो सी ऑल अवर इंजंक्शंस ऑफ शास्त्रास are keeping in view directly or indirectly finally this discovery. For example, so we should not hate anyone. We should love all. Why? If I hate someone and if I try to gain Atma Jnana, everything is Atma but except that rascal. Right? How can I? That pocket is there. Towards which I have got the hatred means I will not be able to gain the knowledge. Other things. By hating someone, whom do we actually hate? If aitadatmyamidam sarvam, if sat itself is the everything, if Brahma itself is everything, and if that means Ishwar also is everything or not? Same thing. Sat Brahma only from the standpoint of Jagat is called Ishwara. Everything is what? Ishwara. I go to temple and worship and adore Ishwara, and when that Ishwara comes in the form of all that being, what do? I hate. See, no, in the case of certain saints, etc., avatars, such episodes are there. In the case of Shirdi Sai Baba, he told a lady, but he was a devotee, I'm hungry, get me some roti or puran puri or something, I think roti or something. So, she ran with a nearby house. She ran because she was happy that he has asked me to bring this. She was preparing it. And she was about to come. A dog came. I think. She was in dilemma. To give the dog or to give that we give the Sadhana Shirdi Baba. What she did. She had that. Otherwise somebody would have driven away. I said. She gave one roti to dog and went. He said, I am happy. I got it. Thank you. I got it. That's it. In other case, it happened that lady bit and driven away this thing and came. See, I came to you and you have beaten me and you are bringing this. So that is how it is. So that is in the case of them, Mahatma said, that Sarvatma Bhava is what? So prominent. And this is because of certain powers, not that otherwise, because of certain powers appearing as the dog, etc. But Sarvatma Bhava, what is Sarvatma Bhava? Atma in me is the Atma in everyone. But that person has done the mistake. That is that person's funeral. Why you bother about that? You mind your own business. We can't correct the world. That's how it is. So, maybe... I have not done anything wrong, but it is done to me. Yes, it is possible. That is true. But let us be serious about our pursuit. Is it not that? So when we are preoccupied in some higher pursuit, the pinpricks in life we don't bother at all. When the exams are nearing, students are what? Not much bothered about the other thing if they are serious about it. Okay? That is how it is. Is it not? So for example, those our forefathers who had fought for the freedom of the nation, the freedom fighter. See how much suffering, etc., they had to undergo. Do you mean to say they had no wife, children, and all whom I had? They had not. But yet, but what? My country must be free. Fired by that ideal, they were undergoing all this development. They were not paying much attention to all these inconveniences in life. So like that, yes, somebody is hated. I am not at fault. The person is at fault. But when I am in this pursuit, I have no time and I have no energy to spend on these things. Let me mind my own business. And the truth is what? My Swarupa is the same Swarupa of each and everyone, including the enemy as such. That's how it is. So that's why I said, maybe I have not discovered the Atma Swarupa, Bhagavat Swarupa, Brahma Swarupa. But Shastra says everything is manifestation of Sat or Parameshara. So therefore, if I hate someone, whom it is, it goes. That's why I say from that standpoint. So that Akashat Patitam Toyam Yathagachati Sagaram Sarvadeva Namaskaraha Keshavam Pratigachati. That's Sanskrit Subhashita. Just as the rain water that falls, directly or indirectly, finally goes where? To the canals, rivulets, finally goes to where? Ocean. So also, Sarva Deva Namaskaraha Keshavam Pratigachati. Salutations offered to all deities, finally goes to whom? Keshava. Again, Keshava means Parameshwar Tattva, not Vaikuntavasi Vishnu alone as such. Corollary also is true. Akashat patitam toyam yathagachati sagaram sarva jiva tiraskaraha keshavam eva pratigachati. So, tiraskara, hatred of all jivas goes to whom? Verily to Keshava. And that Keshava, what do you do? By bhajan you do what? You praise and glorify the Keshava. And you hate this Keshava. So that's it. You know why? That is that disposition. If we, that means we get rid of that, mind has got that disposition by which it can discover this. It is for our own good. Anything, many of this, our Shastras have got that farsightedness. Maybe all may not have been explained. With Shraddha, have that, live that Achara, have that Achara. The mind has to be ready. And one has to gain the knowledge. So yahas abadhyaha. So one who is abadhyaha, so that who is not this, cannot be negated, destroyed. Saha sarvasya atma is the atma of all. No exception whatsoever. Even an ant or an amoeba, its atma is what? This only. Maybe Indra. Even Parameshwara, the I in Parameshwara is what? Same thing. So, sarvasya atma natu kalpitaha. That atma is not falsely projected, not maya karya. So, not a falsely projected, not means it's not a karya. It is the very final karana. Therefore, O Shvetaketu, yad advaitam sat. So whatever that was now, that is ascertained as Advaita non-dual Sat, Tat, that Sat, Tvam Asi, you are. You may say, how is it that? I am Shvetaketu, Mr. Shvetaketu, Namanavaha, you are not a human being. Human being means embodiment, human embodiment comes in picture. You are not this embodiment, you are not Manavaha, so that is what you are. So therefore, this Tat, Tvam, Asi, this Vakya, what does it reveal? Jiva Brahma Aikya. So, because of Jiva Brahma Aikya Bodhana, Tattvam Asi Iti Vakyam. This sentence, because of its nature, what is that? Jiva Brahma Aikya Bodhana is called as Mahavakyam. It is called as Mahavakyam. So, Mahavakya is what? Not big or great or long, Jiva Brahmaika Vaikya Bodhana Vakya. A statement that reveals the identity of Jiva as nothing but Brahma. That is what is called Mahavakya. Any statement which does this function is called Mahavakya. And in this Upanishad, Chandogya Upanishad, 6th chapter, we get this Mahavakya 9 times. It is repeated. 9 times it is repeated. Why it is repeated will be seen after. Now, Shvetaketu is directly pointed out that you are that Sat Swarupa Brahma, not this human embodiment, you are not this human being. A question can come like this. In the Shruti, Aityadatma Vidam Sarvam, Aityadatma Vidam Sarvam was told. Idam Sarvam, this entire Jagat is what Aityadatma means? Has this Atma Sat, as Etad, this Sat Brahma as Atma Swarup. When this is said, does it not, now Shvetaketu comes under the Jagat category or outside the Jagat? He is a part of the constituent of the Jagat. So, Idam Sarvam Jagat, this entire Jagat is Etad, has got Etad Sat as its Atma, means Swarupa, Satya Swarupa. Shvetaketu Swarupa is Sat or otherwise? Sat only. Therefore, by the very statement Etad Atmyam Iti Sarvasya Chetanatloktya, everything is Chetana Swarupa, Sat is told, means Shvetaketu also is necessary. Sat Swarupa, when it is said, Uktya, Advitiyam Siddhyati. Everything is what? Advitiya, non-dual Sat only. Separate Shvetaketu is not there. Nothing is there separate than Advaya Sat. When this is proved, and already it was told earlier, Eka Vidnyanena Sarva Vidnyanam Pratidnyam. Already was told. By knowing the cause, one, all effects are known. It was, and which was told by, asked by who? Uddalaka. And also shown, and the Swarupa of everything is nothing but Atma, which includes Shvetaketu's Swarupa also. If that is the case, why Uddalaka separately told Tattvam Asi? What necessity? You are that Sat Brahma. Aitadatma Idam Sarvam. Everything is what? Everything has what? Atma means Swarupa. What? This Sat as its Swarupa. Shvetaketu also has this Sat as what? Swarupa. So he is not the this. Why that separately Tattvamasi is said? That is the question arises, for which now answer is given here. See, what was the concept of Shvetaketu when he returned from the Gurukula? What? How was it described? Anuchanamani stabdaha. Anuchanamani. You know who am I? I have studied all these Vedas. I can teach now. I can start a Gurukula also. So that is not. That is, he was considering himself to be someone very special, very superior, most exalted. Stabdaha. So apranata svabhavaha. Arrogant. So that means he was so arrogant. So that is, so that was told. Now, referring to that, whom exactly that Anuchanamanitva Stabdatva belongs has to be pointed out to who? Shvetaketu. Hankara, that identification, the body because of which you had that. But in reality, who are you? This Atma Swarupa, Brahma Swarupa, only from that standpoint, so that Tattvamasi had to be told to him. Chichayavanahankaro adhite veda chatushtayam.
Chichayavanahankaro adhite veda chatushtayam.
Tvam tu sakshiva tasyata sadasitvam na chetaraha.
Chichayavan ahankaraha veda chatushtayam adhiti.
Tvam tu tasya sakshi eva. Sakshi eva. Ataha. Tvam sad asi nacha itaraha.
Who studies And who was arrogant? And who considered himself as capable of teaching, etc.? He says, Chichayavan Ahankaraha. Ahankara endowed with Chidabhasa. Otherwise called as what? Jiva. So Chichayavan Ahankaraha Jiva. What does he do? Veda Chatushtayam Adhiti studies four Vedas. Studies four Vedas means not that all Jivas, all individuals study four Vedas. O Shweta Ketu, do you know you studied four Vedas and you are so arrogant, is it not? Who was that one who studied? Chichayavan Ahankara, not Satrupa Atma. So therefore, Chichayavan Ahankara Veda Chatushtayam Adhiti. Whereas as far as you are concerned, do you know who are you? Tvam tu, whereas you, tasya. Tasya means Chichayavan Ahankarasya, or in the case of this Shvetaketu, Anuchanamanitvasya. So one who was so arrogant, etc., of that means actually it is Ahankarasya. Tvam tu, tasya means Ahankarasya, Chichayavan Ahankarasya, Sakshi eva. So you are only Sakshi, the direct illuminator. Definition of Sakshi. Sakshat Anyanapekshaya Ikshati Prakashayati Iti Sakshi. So that which makes you know directly without depending on anything else whatsoever, that is what Sakshi. The Chaitanya only, Sat Brahma only can be Sakshi. So therefore, you are the Sakshi, the one who is the direct illuminator of this, that Ahankara. So therefore, Ataha, who are you now? Tvam Sad Asi. So that wrong notion had to be dispelled because he had that identification in the body. As a result of it, he considered himself to be highly scholastic and that is what arrogant he was. So Tvam, that is that Sat Asi. Itaraha. Itaraha means that Sabhas Ahankara or Chichayavan Ahankara or Anuchanamani Itaraha Nacha. You are not that. Itaraha Nacha. So then lastly, the anvaya can be itaraha nacha. Sadasi, sadasi, itaraha nacha. So, Shvetaketu's wrong notion got dispelled. The result of this knowledge. So, when he was directly pointed out that you are the Brahma Swarupa, Sat Swarupa, he is. That is wrong notion got dispelled. So like this, now that result is shown like, you know, in Mundaka, Vidyate Hridaya Granthihi, Chidyante Sarvasamsha, Chidyante Sarvasamsha yet to come. Something has to be done. Okay. Vidyate Hridaya Granthi was the result. What is Hridaya Granthi? Adhyasa of Antakarna and Atma. Mutually superimposing the features of Atma and Antakarna. Features of Antakarna superimposed on Atma. The Swarupa of Atma superimposed on inner Antakarna. That Hridaya Granthi, not of the heart, that got dispelled or that got cut asunder. Bhinno bhud Hridaya Granthi Shweta Ketor Vivekataha. Dhidosham saushayam marshtum bhuyo bruhityavochata. First line shows that the Hridaya Granthi, this mutual adhyasa between Antakarna Atma of Shvetaketu got, that means snapped off. Second line is something else, we'll see. Anvaya. Vivekataha Shvetaketoho Hridaya Granthi Bhinnaha Abhut. Second line. Dhidosham Samshayam Marshtum Bhuyaha Bruhiti Avochata. Vivekataha, by this Atmanatma Viveka conducted so far in the manner we have seen now, Shvetaketoho Hridaya Granthi. The Hridaya Granthi, that is what the wrong notion of superimposing the Antakarna, the body as the features of I, and the Chaitanya as the features of Antakarna and body, that mutual superimposition, भिन्नः अभूत, गॉट स्नैप्ड ऑफ, गॉट कट असंडर. सो बट नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज, इफ दैट इज द केस, व्हाट शुड श्वेतकेतु शुड से? थैंक यू डैड. ओके, यस टू से नो. He is requesting for further teaching. So that Shruti is there. Bhuya eva ma Bhagavan vidnyapayatu. Oh revered sir. So Bhagavan here is there with respect. Not, don't take that Bhagavan means what? The creator, etc. No, not that Bhagavan as a Bhagavan. The respect for this thing. Oh respected father and respected guru. So Bhagavan. Bhuya eva ma vidnyapayatu. May you please teach me again. Why? Means repetition. He says, no, doubts are there. So that's why dhi dosha. That dhi dosha means saunshaya, saunshaya. So to remove that dhi dosha saunshaya nivruttyartham mananam kartum arabate iti bhava. To remove the doubts, one has to take to manana, reflection, consideration of on what has been taught. So that is what, for that Shvetaketu further requests father to teach again. So like this, 8 times again taught. And every time, whatever the doubt that Shvetaketu had is dispelled. So totally, and every time, so father says, look, I have repeated, but Tattvamasi only. You are the same Tat. No addition, nothing as such. But your doubt was there. For it, illustrations are given. Totally 9 times we get. Now further 8 times are going to come. And 8 doubts will be removed. Question and answer session. Question and answer session between now Shvetaketu and Uddalaka father. Now 8 doubts. Very nicely these 8 doubts are posed and the answer will be given. So, dhi dosham saushayam marshtum. This defect of mind, intellect, namely saushayam, marshtum, to dispel. Marshtum, to dispel. Bhuyaha bruhi. Again, please teach me again. Iti avochata. So requested. Who requested? Shvetaketu requested to his father. The first doubt, let us see now. Can mark it now? The first doubt. So, see, though the doubts of Shvetaketu are expressly not found in Upanishad, they are implied there. In Upanishad you will not find these doubts, but they are implied there. Bhashyakara Shankaracharya in Bhasha has elaborated, which is summarized by Vidyarana Muni here. First doubt and the answer. Answer is where? In the teaching of the father, again telling him Tattvamasi. So first doubt. Sata sampadyate jiva sushupta vityudiritam.
Sata sampadyate jiva sushupta vityudiritam.
Udiritam tatha chet sati sampanno hamityasya kuto nadhihi. Di, da corrected di. Jivaha sushuptau sata ad saha sampadyati iti udiritam. Sata ad saha sampadyati iti udiritam. Tathachet aham sati sampannaha iti asya dhihi kutaha na ad bhavati. Tathachet aham sati sampannaha iti asya dhihi kutaha na ad bhavati. See, in 74 to 76, what was told there? Corresponding to 681. Corresponding to 681 Shruti, in stanzas here 74 to 76, it was told. What was told? Jivaha, jiva individual, sushuptau, swamapiti, swapiti. Is a sushupta, what happens? Sata sampadyati. Satasa. With sat, Brahma. Sampadyati means what? Eki bhavati. Becomes one with Brahma. Iti udiritam. So it was told. In sleep, jiva becomes one with Brahma. Shruti 681, here stanza 74 to 76. If that is case, tathachet, aham sati sampannaha iti asya dhi kutaha na bhavet. He should have the knowledge. Do you know what that? I was one with whom? Sat Brahma. After waking up or at the time of sleep, I am one with whom? Brahma. Let us say, at the time of sleep, not possible because antakarana is not there. But after waking up, why this knowledge is not there? Tatha achet. If this, in sleep, if jiva is merged or has become one with sat afterward, aham, I, who is that? Sati sampannaha, sati ekabhutaha. Me is the one who was one with whom? Sat iti kutaha on a dhihi. Dhi means knowledge. Kutaha na bhavati. Why does he not know his swarupa, that sat is my swarupa, because he was already one with sat swarupa. So the request is to explain with drishtanta. Why do I not get that knowledge? In sleep, what was that? I was one with who? Sat swarupa Brahma. This Brahma sat is my swarupa. Why does he not gain knowledge? So that is now answered here. Let us see.
Om swasti prajabhya paripadayantam nyayena margena mahim mahishah go brahmane vino bhavantu kale varshatu parjanya prativi sasya shalini deshoyam shobharahitya ब्राह्मणा संतु निर्भयाः ओम सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे संतु निरामयाः सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् असतो मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय Rudyorma Amritam Gamaya Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purna Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti